We can turn to Louisiana and Baton Rouge, where there's a mother who is forced to make an unthinkable decision of either carrying her baby to term, even though the doctors tell her that her child will not survive, or to go to another state like Florida to have an abortion. This woman, Nancy Davis, and here she is pictured, is 13 weeks pregnant with her second child, but the top of the child's skull, it's not developed. It's completely missing. And Davis was told, quote, or she's told WAFB9 that it's hard knowing that, you know, I'm carrying it to bury it. That's right, because Davis got her first ultrasound at Women's Hospital when she was 10 weeks pregnant. She and her boyfriend were excited to welcome their new baby, but soon learned that the pregnancy would not go as planned. Davis says her baby was diagnosed with acrania, a rare and fatal condition where the baby's skull fails to form in the womb. And according to health experts, babies with this condition only survive minutes to hours after birth. But because Davis's life was not in danger and the baby's condition doesn't fall under Louisiana Department of Health's list of qualifying conditions, she was denied an abortion. Yeah, that's right. And that list includes some 24 congenital disorders and chromosomal abnormalities, and also a catch-all exception. But the thing is that you're gonna have mothers like this in positions where they are carrying it to bury it, when they could simply be provided with the necessary healthcare, which would be an abortion. Ben.
I mean, is there any better evidence that we have abortion laws and exceptions to these draconian laws being crafted by people that don't know what they're talking about? That they came up with a list of 14 or whatever it is conditions that didn't include half of the skull is missing. They didn't think that is one that should be on the list of an allowable abortion in a state that at least still allows, due to some abnormalities, some abortions in certain restricted cases still. And she is now faced with such a difficult choice to have to take a trip out of state, take time off of work, presumably, to go and have a medical procedure, not in the state where she lives, because they won't accommodate something so obvious, a child that will be dead, that is doomed to that. And if there's any other more added difficulty to this, she also has to think about whether she even wants to go to Florida, which nobody should want to do. And so she has that as well. You gotta go do all this and gotta step into Florida, a lawless death state, as I like to refer to it, the penis of America. So there's that.
Yeah. And the thing is, it's like, you know, who knows if she even has the money to travel to Florida, all the things that are gonna be involved. Also, the thing is it can be quite emotional. Like she had mentioned that she and her boyfriend were looking forward to the baby. So having to even go through the abortion process can be emotional. And we don't necessarily know if her boyfriend has the financial assets to be able to travel as well. It's just, there's so many things that just scream, why can't Louisiana, why can't states provide and offer people the healthcare that they need? But hey, this is the United States of America. And clearly,
it also just shows yet again how this issue is not what these right-wing white male politicians purport it to be. She doesn't even state what her opinion is on abortion. She wanted this baby. She just has a circumstance where the baby is going to die. It's effectively already dead on arrival, and she's being denied the ability to take something that is developing incorrectly and not into a viable human life already at 13 weeks. And that's the laws. Even people who are saying, we want a baby, they claim, oh, it's to stop people from being irresponsible. It's to stop people from using abortion as birth control. They wanted this child. They will try again. But she's being forced to go through this traumatic situation because our country has lost its way.
Yeah. Wow, shucks. I would say we never knew where it's going. I think it's actually going reverse, but without a doubt, absolutely. And the thing is, remember, she's gonna have to give birth to this baby. So all of the costs and expenses associated with that on top of it, it's just wrong through and through.